Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. On behalf of CII Radio, we present to you lesson number 715 of our daily Naseehah and advice. Our topic today is Andalus, Muslim Spain. We know that one of the nearest countries to Iberia at that time, the Jazeera, and you know, it was together, that is like an island and so forth, so was Portugal and Spain. Nevertheless, here in Morocco, North Africa, we find the Muslims were ruling there. This is the 92nd year after the Hijrah. People who send their sons, their daughters across the ocean and into Iberia and Spain and those places for further education. So there was a person, Rodrix, and he used to abuse the ladies and so forth and the young girls. Here in North Africa, we find a person by the name of Julian. He sent his daughter and news came that his daughter also was abused and harassed and so forth. He came to the Muslim and Musa bin Nusayr was in charge of that area of North Africa. And he said, okay, we will investigate and we can't just go there. Then when it was confirmed, yes, it is true. Imagine non-Muslims used to complain to Muslims because they knew the Muslims had justice. Then Musa bin Nusayr said, no, I have to ask the Khalifa and the leader, Walid. And he agreed. And then, mashallah, we find that Tariq bin Ziyad, 22, 23 years old, in his four ships, 7,000 people sailed from North Africa into Iberia. And lo and behold, at Jabal Tariq, we find till today, it is named after him, the Mount of Tariq. So in that area, you must remember, he gave that memorable khutbah and told his people that amamakum al-adu wa wara'akum al-aba, that amamakum al-bahar wa wara'akum al-adu. So meaning that in front of you, amamakum al-adu, that in front of you are the enemy, wa wara'akum al-bahar, and behind you is the ocean. And they burned the boats and they said, oh Allah, we want to establish Islam here, otherwise we give our life. Before disembarking, one, two nights or that before, he saw Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Khulafa, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar and them, radiallahu anhum, in his dream, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu an, and like victory was assured to him. So therefore the iman increased, the conviction increased. It was in Ramadan, the end of Ramadan, 28-29, and the 92nd year after the Hijrah, lo and behold, in Wadi al-Lakki, that day we find that victory was given to the Muslims. The Muslims ruled Spain, Andalus, for about 8 centuries, 800 years. Today when you go, you'll cry. If you go to Qurtuba, that masjid was the biggest masjid in the world, bigger than Masjid Nabawi with a roof on. But today it is transformed into a church. When I entered there, the police came and said no prayer. When you go to the first surf, you will still see the musallas and carpets and the niche there. And they tell you no prayer, so you just make dua and tears roll down. When this ummah got involved in dunya only, forgot the deen, forgot the dawah and inviting people, then our masajid also became churches as we saw. And we know in South Africa and other parts of the world, when the work of Dawud goes on, then remember, churches become masajid, synagogues become masajid. So that's the big lesson we learn. Muslim Andalus produced scholars like Allama Qurtubi Rahimahullah, whose tafsir is well known throughout the world. Produced scholars in hadith like Hafiz ibn Abdul Barr. Produced scholars like Qazi Munzir. So great, great people, the Maliki fiqh thrived in that part of the world, in Andalus and so forth. When you come there to Granada, you see Hamra Palace. And there again you will see La Ghaliba Illallah written everywhere. None can give you victory and power except Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. And remember that it is so magnificent. with everything now in the hands of them, and it is a money spinner for them. Thousands of people come, O Muslim, take the lesson of Spain. Don't be so proud with our darulums and madrasas, our masajid and everything else. That same Allah who gave it to us can snatch it away also when we become engrossed in these worldly activities. May Almighty Allah protect our institutions, our masajid. Barakallahu feek. Salaamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.